Hello everyone, welcome to Master to Teach step by step guide. In this video, we are going to learn what is Google Classroom, how to run online classes using Google Classroom, wow feature of Google Classroom which you can use to handle the online classes. We will also see an example of each feature. I will try my best to explain step by step. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Okay, let's start. One of the most amazing tools of Google is Google Classroom. Google Classroom is especially developed for the online classes where a teacher or a group of teachers can handle all the students fully online, where interaction and communication between the teacher and the student became more strong and effective. For Google Classroom, you need a Google account, which you can create it easily online. You can either download the Google Classroom apps from Google Play Store or simply open from your computer browser. Let's learn step by step how to start Google Classroom and how to use it, as well as how can we conduct online classes using Google Classroom. First of all, open your browser and type classroom.google.com. Before starting, make sure you are logged in with your accounts so that you can access and handle the classes from mobile as well as from anywhere wherever you are online. There are two types of role, one is teacher and another is student. As I have already mentioned you before, this application is used for online classes where teacher and students can conduct the online classes easily in an organized way. As you can see, there are nothing on the page. No classes have been created and started yet before from this account, so that it's showing don't see any existing classes, try another account. At the top right corner of the page, you can see the plus sign. Click on it, where you will get two options. Number one, join class, another is create class. Here, create class is for the teachers, where the teacher creates the classes, and join class is for the students, where students can join the class which is created by the teacher. For better understanding, I am showing in two different browsers with a different account. One as a teacher, whereas another as a student, so that I can show you how the classroom works. Without creating class, student can't join the classroom. So that, let's start from creating a class as a teacher. Click in the create class options. It will pop up a message in which you have to accept that you are not using the classroom as a school with students. If you are using this application officially with your school domain email ID, you have to sign up for a free G Suite for Education account. For now, click on the checkbox and continue. As soon as you click on the continue, you will see a pop-up where you can create a new class. Name the class like Computer Lecturer Week 1. There may be different sections in the class, and you can specify for which section you are going to create a class, like Section A, Section B, Section C, etc. And you have to specify the subject, for which subject you are creating a class, like Computer Science, Mathematics, etc. You can specify the room number as well. In this way, you can create different classes for different subjects, section-wise and class-wise. Let me create a new class for now. Class name, Master to Teach Online Class 1. Section, let me put M. Subject, let me put Computer Science. Room, let me put as Mount Everest. Click on Create button. As you can see, the new features are included in the Google Classroom. We have created a new class successfully. As you can see from here, we can post the message information to the class, but no student is included in it. Now, let's move to add students in the classroom. Students can be added in two ways. As a teacher, you can invite them to join the classroom. As a student, they can join the classroom using classroom code, which we will see in a few minutes. To add a student as a teacher, click in the People tab, where you can see two categories, teacher and student. Here you can invite to add teacher as well as students. Click on the plus signs and enter the student email ID to invite the students to join the class. You can invite more than one student in bulk by placing more student ID here. Similarly, to the teacher, That means more than one teacher can handle a single class. Another way to add students is by providing classroom code to the students. Every class has a unique classroom code, which you can see here. Share this code to the students, and using this code, students can join the classroom themselves. Let's join the classroom as a student. Same as before, open the classroom.google.com page. Students must log in with their ID and click on the plus sign, and this time click in Join Class. A pop-up will appear to join a class where it says ask your teacher for a classroom code, then enter it here. Paste the classroom code and click on Join. In the teacher section, you can see how many students and who have joined the class. You can easily mute or remove the student as well. Let's move forward how to regulate class and how the teacher and student communicate. In Stream tab, the teacher can post any class materials information to the students. The post can be posted right away, schedules the post, or creating draft and post it later as well. The teacher can attach the files, links, share Google Drive files, even YouTube videos. You can post, schedule, or save draft. For now, let's post it. As soon as you place the post, all the students will get the notification in their email as a new announcement with details from where students can open the classroom as well. In Google Classroom, students can view the post and assess the attachment. Students can ask questions or any confusion as a comment on the post as well, and the teacher can also reply to them. In this way, teacher and students can communicate online in an organized way. Let's see more on Google Classroom. You can categorize the post as well so that students can access the resources easily. Let me create a topics like ebook resources. Lecture slides. Assignments. Quiz. Now, while sharing materials to students, you can select in which topics you are going to post. You can attach the document. Also, you can create docs files or slides or sheets from online very easily as well and attach within the post. Post the material which can assess all the students as soon as you post it. Another good functionality is you can assign the assignment to the students online easily as well. You can set the marks it will cover, due date of submission. Google Classroom will track all the student submission date and inform all the late submission information as well. Even you can create a rubric to let students know how their assignment will be evaluated as well. As soon as the assignment posted, all students will get a notification in their email with the subject new assignment. Students can post a comment if any confusion directly in the assignment. The student will submit the assignment and marks it as done. Whereas, teacher can view individual student assignment and give them marks out of full marks online. The teacher can set up in setting whether student can see the obtained marks or not. In this way, the teacher can assign the assignment and student can submit assignments easily online using Google Classroom. Also, student can send private comments to the teacher as well. Another wow feature of Google Classroom is questions. You can take an exam online as well. Also, you can have online survey to get feedback from the students. In this way, you can conduct online classroom using Google Classroom. I hope you learned from this video. If you have any question or comments, please make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. Also, be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you very much for watching. Check us out for more in IT tutorial and guide on website mastertoteach.com. And we will see you again soon. Bye.